They be quick to accuse when you got different views. Just know you gon' pay the price based off the item you choose.
Many times in the culture, hit you with MK Ultra. I knew you was a vulture, Holy Ghost get the ushers. No, I can't trust you, shock you, deny you, fluster. Crashing down, I was cluttered, doing this so subtle. Falling out through the rubble, remember this in jungle. The top, I was gonna get something, the middle gotta stay hunting. Why the rush up for nothing? 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 Agitated illusion, only built for confusion. The institution, modern day execution. Think I knew the solution, maybe not should I do it. Just put it in the music, just put it in the music.
Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. I can't give up about what they say. They've been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drip, can't catch my wave. You're burning out.
Defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
Now left side, a completion to his tight end. And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. 12 yards there and a first down.
And what a nice example there of a tight end doing exactly what he needs to do. How about how he worked his way to the outside, made sure he secured the catch, and then anything after that, we count that as a bonus, and indeed, he gets enough for the first down.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Play fake. He'll look to throw. That's complete to his tight end, Higby. This winds up a gain of four to the 41. Complete.
I think it's okay that they didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and six. Now a dump off here complete, and he'll get it out to midfield. Jones, and they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
As a passer, you're always trying to find that open window to throw the ball downfield. How about this one? Right in the middle of the field, right in the heart of a defense.
First carry for Austin Ekeler, and they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10.
No gain on the play. Second
from the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. He'll get this to Ekeler. I don't think it's a surprise they're throwing the football early. We expected that. They told us they were going to come out firing, but 4-for-4 on the opening drive. They like that.
They don't just like it. They love it because now everyone gets locked in. The confidence jumps up. Everyone's easy about what they're doing out there. And by the way, they look at the sideline thinking to themselves and expressing, just keep throwing it. We're doing pretty well.
Down toward the midway point in quarter one. They go play action here on first down. The ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
From the 34, they'll come to the line on second and 10. The throw down the field, caught by his running back. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard. This will be play number 9 coming up on this relatively long opening drive as they look to convert on third down. They'll try and run for the first with Taylor. And that one going nowhere from the start as he's met in the backfield and goes backwards. And now the Bengal defense here calling a timeout. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. And this may be a big early turning point in this Super Bowl. They're going to go for it on fourth down here. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. And he's going to have his running back. It's complete. And taking it to the 15-yard line before it's brought down. That's a fourth down pickup of 10 yards and an opportunity certainly missed on the defensive side. Successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. Out of the gun, Ekeler running it. He takes this down to about the 12 for a gain of 3. The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7.
It's a pickup of 3. Brings up 2nd and 7 at the 12-yard line.
Simple tap pass, but it pays off in a big way.
And sometimes the simple stuff causes the most problems for a defense because there's a breakdown in communication there. When that receiver goes behind the line of scrimmage and it looks like he's going in motion, someone either has to go with him or he has to be passed off to another defender.
And he takes it into the end zone for a Panthers touchdown. With the first touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Panthers take it right down and score on the opening drive. A long opening drive, but a very successful opening drive. We call that methodical, I guess, when it takes that many plays.
Methodical and almost like a boxing match where you're hitting them with body blows. They can withstand them here. Look, they gave up the touchdown, but you don't feel like a knockout is there. But they keep doing that in the fourth quarter. that's when the knockout occurs.
It becomes tough for that defense if they're on the field that long. We'll see if they can continue that in future drives.
Fielded in the end zone.
And no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
Burrow going to lead up the Bengals here, first and 10 at their 25-yard line. He'll drop to throw. He'll try and set up the screen to Hines. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here. This Super Bowl, of course, just a huge one for this head coach. The first time he's walked the sidelines in a game of this magnitude, and you know, I might normally ask the cliche, what's going through his mind right now? But maybe the better question, CD, what do you think are the pitfalls of being a first-time head coach in this game?
Well, you know it's something that he thought about, Brandon, and he had to, and he was thinking about it long before he got to this stage. As the season progressed and he saw that his team was good, if he was smart, he started to make plans right then and there. Reach out to other coaches who've been there before. Find out how they handled winning, losing, handling all the ticket situations, travel, practice, all those things, and then trust your gut, make your best decision, and put it all out there and give your team their best chance to win.
Back to Mixon on first down. And he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. After 1-7-0 on EA Sports. So from Panther territory now, it's first and 10 at the 47. Fighting him off, and some room to work. They'll cross over out of bounds right at the 25. 23 yards on the pickup there, and a first.
They're making it look easy out there. Another first down. So far on this drive, let me do this little bit of math here. Four plays, three first downs.
That's a pretty good recipe for success. Mixon with a first down carry. And he's going to take this one down to about the 23-yard line.
Brought down.
2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense, rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult.
And take this into the end zone for Bengal TV. 23 yards for the touchdown. And the Bengals are an extra point away from tying up this football game. It's up and good, and we're tied at 7 here in quarter number 2. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. Taken in the end zone. And this will not be returned. It will come out to the 25.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before, because that...
He's got it in! Complete! And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. 36 yards on the play.
Justin at the 39-yard line.
Thank you. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. They give to Taylor out of the gun. And he only manages a couple here, down to about the 38-yard line. The last run good for two. Here's second and 8.
2 yards on the pickup. It's second and 8.
From the gun, it's Taylor. And he's going to be close to a first down as the tackle made at the Bengals 28.
Yeah, once more, strong running. Excellent blocking at the point of attack. They got a nice little drive brewing right here.
First down, Eckler. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Give him 10 there, good enough for a Panther first down.
First and 10 at the 18-yard line.
Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. On the screen, this is Eckler. That catch good for only a couple.
So many things have to come together just right for a screen pass to break for big yardage. The blocking, the timing of the pass to the runner, everything has to fit together just right. But on that play, the defense was able to disrupt things and hold it to a short game.
So second and 8 here after the pass play for 2 yards on first down.
Stressful spot when he takes off and runs because a lot of guys have coverage responsibilities.
Good job of rallying, though, because I thought when he first took off, he might pick up the first down. Boy, a call like this, certainly tougher to make in a Super Bowl, but they'll go for it on fourth down. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. He's got it for a Panther touchdown. And the Panthers have taken the lead.
I thought that was a nice job there, feeling the pressure and rolling out away from it and keeping the play alive. And I think he did it with the idea that his tight end would find his way free in the end zone, and his confidence was rewarded.
Extra point try good by Gano. And that makes the score 14-7.
Graham Gano to kick off for
Gano now, following the touchdown here to kick it away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. But ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
At their own 23-yard line.
The Bengals drive about to get going. And that last touchdown drive, a good mix of pass and run. Defensively, they just looked a little out of whack.
And it's so hard to stay up with an offense that has things going so well, where you're guessing and guessing wrong play after play. So what you need is someone on the defensive side of the ball,
leader, right,
to make a big play.
Yeah.
Throw that balance out of whack. That's what you're looking for now. Not worrying so much about guessing what the play call is.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. This time Burrow will look to throw. They'll set up the screen here to Mixon. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. Good pick up there on first as the screen pass gets him 8.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass, looked like it was coming together, looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
Second down, here's Mixon. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
First and 10 at the 46-yard line.
From the shotgun, it's Burrow. And this one caught by Travis Kelce. And a gain of 4 gets him right to the midfield stripe. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down.
Second and 6 at the 50-yard line.
Out of the shotgun, they run with Mixon. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40.
Cincinnati Bengals. First and 10 at the 38-yard line.
A quick throw into the hands of Rager. And he'll be out of bounds as he gets it down to the 30 there. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way deck. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
A gain of 5, good enough for the first down. Going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
16-yard line.
Now another timeout called for by the offense as the clock will stop with 20 seconds to go in the first half. From the gun to give to Mixon. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. Now the Bengals going to signal for their third and final timeout, as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action. Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. And now they will throw it with Burrow. Complete with a clock down now to 13 seconds. He was trying to find Justin Jefferson there. And it's second down. From the shotgun, Joe Burrow. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Burrow's pass incomplete. Out of the end zone. Brings up a third down and 10 yards to go.
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10. Out of the gun, it's Burrow. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. So we've reached halftime here in the Super Bowl. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. Okay, Coach, appreciate it. A one-touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half.
Graham Gano to kick off for Carolina.
These two teams sat through a longer-than-usual 30-minute wait, but we're back in action here in the Super Bowl. Fielded in the end zone. And he will not bring it out. It's a touchback. The Bengals drive about to get going. And both of these defenses have been stifling these last few drives offensively. Just not able to get anything going. So what needs to change?
And a lot of the guys will go back and review, so to speak, because everyone has someone assigned to. How did each play work? Okay, what do we use that kind of worked for us during this game? Try and get back to some of those plays, as well as the possibility of showing something you haven't shown already in this game and trying to change things up.
We'll see if they take the advice of Mr. Davis. Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete. And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. That's a big loss of three, and it brings up third down. I don't know how well our microphones are picking it up for those of you at home, but Charles, you and I can hear it. A lot of groans right now coming from this crowd.
I don't know if we're picking up what's happening in the stadium or from the people who are supporting this team at home, because it's coming through loud and clear to you and me. This offense, they've been stuck in neutral much of the game. And on that last play, they actually won.
And that's caught inside the 35. Cincinnati score. Jalen Reagor, his second touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Bengals are an extra point away from tying up this football game. And we've got a good one brewing. We're all knotted up at 14.
That ties the game at 14.
Nothing separating these two teams on the scoreboard as the kick's away here.
Takes this about 5 yards deep.
The Panthers take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And their lead has evaporated in this third quarter. It's tied once more as they begin with a first and 10. First play of the drive there is incomplete. He couldn't get the hook up there that time with Thomas. That'll bring up second down.
Oh, that's got to frustrate him a little bit, because it nearly got to him there, and it would have been the first sack of the game instead. They're able to influence the release, and they did force the incomplete pass.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Flush to his right. Got his man, Robbie Anderson. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7. Past the 30 to the 32. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3. Third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. And tight coverage there. It's knocked away, incomplete.
Quarterbacks work all the time on manipulating a defense with their eyes and their head movement. In this case, he just stared the receiver down. That allowed for excellent coverage, able to knock that one away.
This offense 2 for 2 converting on these thus far, so why not try again here on fourth down? They'll go for it. They're indeed going for it as they look to throw. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. Just a gain of 3, but they'll certainly take it as they convert on fourth down.
First and 10 at the 36-yard line.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Drop to throw. Find time to his left. The left side completion to Jones. All the way down to the 17-yard line. A big play there for the Panthers. 47 yards.
At the 17-yard line.
So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. And they go the wrong way here, knocked back to the 20. But despite the completion, they're going to wind up losing 3 there, second down. Chased out left. And they'll be caught in the end zone for the Carolina touchdown by DJ Moore.
Tuck
DJ Moore there to make the grab. And the Panthers have broken our tie as they take the lead. It's up and good, and that'll make the score 21-14.
The score, Panthers 21, Bengals 14.
Touchdown here to kick it away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Bengals take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
That's the reason we go for circle round twice for the encore. You know, you know.
The Bengals drive about to get going. They did what they had to do to start this third quarter. Went down, got the touchdown to cut the lead, but the matching touchdown a moment ago, and we're right back where we started at halftime.
Yeah, exactly right, partner. They had a little bounce in their step after scoring that first touchdown, but the defense gave one up. And that's the problem right now. Can they get better play from their defense while they continue to score on offense?
24-yard line.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. Once again, they run with Mixon, and he'll get this one up to the 26. After getting stuffed on first down, not much better there. 2-yard gain.
A gain of 2 brings up third and 9.
On third down, Mixon. Space to maneuver up the 40. As he'll get this one up to the 44-yard line. 18 yards on that one, and the Bengals are moving. First down.
Well, that last run makes this a 100-yard night. I've loved the way he's hit the holes. He's been quick, he's been decisive, and he's been a whole lot of fun to watch.
First down, Mixon, and he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. Call that a gain of 5 as the clock ticks inside of 2 minutes to go now in the third.
That's a really good gain right there. They pick up 5 yards halfway to a first down. The only problem now in the huddle, everyone's going to want to touch the football. Be a lot of chattering now because they've seen that they can move the line of scrimmage.
Second down now. Mixon, just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 3rd and 3.
Whenever we talk about the best strong safeties, one word constantly comes up, and that's instincts. Being able to diagnose run or pass and make the appropriate moves.
He crashed down hard there. He was ready for that running play. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain there, and it leads to a 4th down. Well, the offense is not leaving the field. They're going to stay out and go for it on 4th and 3. They'll try and throw for the ball. Got an open man finding Jefferson. And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first. One quarter remains here in the Super Bowl. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
The score, Panthers 21, Bengals 14.
The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's 1st and 10. Here's Burrow setting up to throw it. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. Well-executed 22-yard gain.
I like the design that we're seeing right there. This is what they need. Down by a touchdown here in the fourth. They just need to keep working their way downfield. And when they see openings, take their shots.
And not much to speak of there. Maybe a yard down to the 20.
Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run. Burrow throw, and that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on third down.
Normally you think the tight end's going to be able to catch the football and handle that contact, but in this case, maybe a little too much target to hit. That one was timed well, incomplete.
Third down, Burrow. This ball complete to Rager. And he is not going to get to the marker as they stop him short at the 14. The completion good for only six, and that'll bring up fourth. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
The first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. If they're going to have a shot in this Super Bowl, they're going to need this one on fourth down. Here we go. It's Burrow on fourth down. Smith. And the Bengals are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. They opt to go for it, and they get it. First and goal after a pickup of five. And a short pickup there down to about the nine. It's a gain of a yard, and it'll set up second and goal. Defensively, pretty good start there with their backs against the wall.
That's a win for the stop troops right there. And if I'm them, I get a little bolder now. They won the first battle. Keep coming after them. Put the pressure on them.
Gets this one quickly out wide. And this play doesn't go anywhere. Backwards, losing yardage to the 11.
I thought that wasn't a bad time to call the screen. I thought late game, down on the scoreboard, had to figure they were expecting a pass downfield.
Yeah, so the edge rushers, they're coming. That could have hit big. You're right. Good recognition defensively to snuff that one out. Third and goal, a big play in this Super Bowl. Now it's Burrow. Flushed out right. And down he goes. Pressure gets him back at the 14.
We've watched this a long time, and I still don't believe we get it. Third and long. Why are you calling play action?
Yeah, because they're not going to bite defensively, right?
No, not at all. I did have a coach explain to me years ago that for some teams, that's how they have to do their pass protection and their line blocking. But to me, it seems silly.
Yeah, they're silly that leads to a play action sack. So an interesting call there to take the three. I mean, I guess they're thinking that their hands were tied, but, you know, fourth quarter, that field goal might not help them that much in the end.
Yeah, eventually they're going to need the touchdown. The thinking must have been, they didn't feel confident about picking it up there, hoping maybe on defense they can get better field position, get a turnover, get a better play, and then they'll have a chance to attack the end zone.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And the tension ratcheting up all around. A one-score game.
Fourth quarter of the Super Bowl. This is what you folks came for. Every play with the potential to win or lose a title as they look to drain some time off this clock.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice, safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
They'll come up now, second and four from the 31.
Teammates to accept that throw, because for the most part what they've seen, it's been pretty sensational.
And inside the 20 before he's brought down. It's a Bengal first down, a pickup of 11. He continues to have a big night here under the lights carrying the football.
And some guys prefer night games. For whatever reason, their bodies react a certain way. They love the spotlight. Maybe that's what it is. The best seats in the house, the ones where he's carrying the football for his offensive teammates. The worst seats, the 11 guys trying to tackle him on defense.
First and 10, and they've got three tight ends out there. A jumbo package look. Before he's taken down, as that will take us to the 2-minute warning. So the Bengals in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They come up on a second down now in a game that looks like it's going to go down the wire. Another 2-yard gain there, but they'll need to do better this time. It's 3rd and 6.
I like the call there because that was one to take time off the clock and get them closer to getting out of here with a W. In the mind of the play caller, all you want to hear is tick, tick, tick.
On 3rd down, Mixon. And they're going to mark him down short. It's a pickup of 4, but they're still a yard short here with 4th down forthcoming. And he's got the first down as he gets it to the 8. They only got a couple, but a couple's all that they needed as they convert on 4th.
1st and goal at the 8-yard.
Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown. And that's what they're gunning for on 1st and goal. And he throws his way into the end zone for a Bengal touchdown. An 8-yard touchdown run. And the Bengals are going to jump back in front.
Wow, I know it's a never-say-never situation, but to me, that looks like that's the one that's going to finish them off.
The score that puts them in front here late, but now you've got to rally your kick team, don't you, and say the last thing we need is a big return.
And what happens is guys get overeager, get out of their lane because they're so excited they want to make the last tackle. You mess up, could come back at you a long way.
No return on this one as the fair catch is single four and taken.
The Panthers take over 1st and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They're only in need of a field goal, a decent amount of time on the clock. So tell me if I'm wrong. You don't have to be too panicked here.
No, not at all. I agree with you. And this is where your preparation and your confidence comes into play. They've worked on these situations.
They practice this all the time.
They know what they want to get done. And in a lot of cases, the great competitors, they love this situation. They think they can go ahead and get it done.
They practiced it. We'll see if practice makes perfect. Steps away to his left. Throw left side complete. That's Jones. And he'll go out of bounds. It appears right at the 45. 7 yards to pick up there.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going.
They'll look to throw on the move to his left. And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as he'll stop it with 25 ticks remaining on the clock. The Bengals going to use the second of their timeouts. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. He'll look to throw, rolling to his left. Looking left side, and he's got a man. It's Jones. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first.
First and 10 at the 31-yard line.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Back to throw. Side complete. It's Jones. The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the ballgame. That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves them with a very manageable second and one. He's back to throw. He'll buy some time right. He'll get this to Eckler. And able to get this down inside the 15, either the 13 or 14 before he's out of bounds. Now what a first down pickup of 8.
First and 10 at the 13-yard line.
Zone now. They'll look to throw. He's going to take off with it. And it looks like he'll be just a yard shy of the 5 here as he's out at the 6. Nice work to get 7 out of that, and it's second down.
Brings up second and 3.
From the 6 now on second and 3. Shot. They'll look to throw. This will be caught at about the 6. Now there's the timeout. Signal 4 with 2 seconds to go. And the field goal unit likely trying to send this one to overtime. They're trying to keep the drive going. This will be play number 8. It's 3rd and 2. To throw. And this is caught. One play for the Angels. It's a touchdown to win the Super Bowl on the final play.
Brandon, you know I love boxing, right? You know I love big fights, right? I had given them the standing eight count a few times along the way. And look at how this one ended.
Yeah, they had, well, I guess nine lives just like a cat, kept fighting, and there in the end making the huge play to get the game winner.
I guess that's the epitome of you always have a puncher's chance.
That's it. It's all over. And the Carolina Panthers are your Super Bowl champions. For the victors getting to hoist that Lombardi Trophy, you know, we've talked to guys that have done it, and they say there's no better feeling in sports.
I don't know how there can be. The journey to get to this game is incredible. And then to finally break through and win it when all eyes are on this game alone because there's nothing else going on, that's just got to be absolutely amazing. That, the task, incredible. But the accomplishment, forever.